Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we'll try something in acrylic colors. So this is the reference photo I have chosen. As you can see, it is a colorful, beautiful duck swimming in water. And that is the primary reason why I chose this photograph. For me, this photograph depicts freedom, confidence, as well as calmness. So now, let's take a look at this photograph properly. So first, we'll divide this photograph in three different components. First is the beautiful duck. Second is the rhythmic flow of water. And last but not the least, the reflection of duck in the water. So let's begin with the painting. One thing we need to remember while using acrylic paints that they dry pretty quickly. So we need to work very fast. To begin with, I've drawn the basic outline of the main subject here, which is duck, on paper first. I have used layering method in this painting. To begin with, I have applied a thin coat of base colors. These colors need not be exactly the same as we are going to apply subsequent layers with proper colors and shading. As you can see, we are just giving the basic shape and shade to the main subject. We'll be doing the detailing in the subsequent layers. But do make sure that the shade of this basic layer is at least slightly similar to what we want in the final product, or else it will be difficult to mask the color and the final result will look very patchy. So now we are done with the base coat. Similarly, we'll just give a wash of base shade to the background also. So this is how it looks after the first layer. Now we'll start with detailing. So we'll concentrate on one part at a time now. Just observe how I am working on the head of the duck. Instead of directly doing the final details, I'll first do the shading of the head part as it appears on the reference photograph. You can see how I am merging various shades of yellow, green and blue, along with a tinge of white and black. While placing layers of color, I always prefer to go from darker to lighter shade. So after finishing the first layer of bland and base colors, I'm proceeding with the shading. While blending, you should be fast enough because, as I've already mentioned, the acrylics dry pretty fast. Now as we proceed with the detailings, as you can see, it is starting to get a better look. While painting feathers, we just have to keep in mind one thing. Since they are not placed in a single plane, the angle and reflection of light makes them shine differently from each other. Also, light plays a very major role in it. As you can see in the reference photograph also, the bulge or the convex portion of the duck gets the major reflection or shine in the light. So to create the 3D look of your painting, you have to observe that and replicate that. Now starting with the wings of the duck, I took maximum time finishing this portion. Either I couldn't get the shade right or the texture right. As you can see, I got the texture right in this one, but the shade was very different from the reference photograph. I had to redo this particular area at least 3 to 4 times to get it correct. After trying a couple of times, I decided to concentrate on the background first and then get back to this portion. The background gives actual depth to this painting. While doing background, we first have to identify the lighter as well as darker areas and then proceed accordingly. Also, it is important to create the illusion of depth and the flow of water. Also, we have to make sure that our brush strokes are in the direction of the flow of water. Most important thing in this is create the ripples of water. You can see how the different gradation of colors are used to show the movement of water. So first we have finished painting the water surrounding the duck. And as we move farther away from the duck, you can see how different areas are made darker and lighter to give proper depth to the water. We have to check the reference photo properly for the reflection and see how each and every portion of the duck reflects in the water. So once we finish with the background, we can get back to the remaining portions of our painting. As I have told you, I couldn't get the wing portion right initially. So I redid it with the same technique but different shade, and now it is perfect. When everything else is done, we can just give our attention to the fine detailing and the finishing of this painting. So this is how our final painting looks. Do let us know how did you like the painting as well as video. If you like this video, please press the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.